सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमामस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माणुजाति गुरुवेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायन्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे ननु इष्टादिकारिणां धूमादिमार्गेण चंद्रलोकं गतानां तद्देवानां अन्नन्तं देवा भक्षयन्ति इति देवैः भक्ष्यत्वं श्रूयते. एज एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू दि सेवेंथ सूत्र भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सरस्वती सेज ननु इष्टादिकारिणां धूमादिमार्गेण व्हाट वाज सीन अर्लियर इज अश्रुतत्वादिति चेन्न इष्टादिकारिणां प्रतीतेः. The Ishtapurti karmas are prescribed for the grihastha so that he can attain the phala. Therefore, the jivasya ashrutatva, if jiva shabda has not been heard in the statement, if you say, then you have to infer the jiva alone by linga, because there is ishta and purti as prescribed karma which the jiva alone can do. Therefore, jiva shabda, even if it is not a shruti, meaning it is not literally mentioned, still jiva word has to be understood, because no other entity can do the karma. Ishta and purti are prescribed for the jiva alone. So now, ishtadikarinam dhumadimargena chandralokam gatanam. So the jivas who have gone to chandraloka through the Dhumadi Marga, and who are these who are moving towards the Chandraloka, or who has gone to the Chandraloka? They are the ones who have done Ishtapurti Karma. What has said about them in the Shruti? Tad Devanam Annam. They are what? They are Anna for the Devas, Devatas. And then what? Tam Deva Bhakshenti. Deva, Devas consume them. Iti devaihi bhakshyatvam shruyate. So kesham bhakshyatvam shruyate chandralokam gatanam. Those who have gone to chandraloka, those are consumed by the devas as anna. This is what the shruti says. Therefore, ataha katham tesham sarvakarma phala upabhoga siddhirityataha. Then how is it that you say this ishtapurti karma phala siddhi will be there for these jivas? Because they are told that you do ishtapurti karma, you will get punya, and thereby you will attain chandraloka, and you will get more sukha than you have in this prithvi loka. But after having gone there, they become food for devas. What kind of a sukha is this? Therefore, swakarma phala upabhoga siddhir nasti. Where is the accomplishment in that becoming anna for the devas? Whereas what the jiva is expecting to attain is sukha. Becoming food for others is not sukha. This is the objection by the Purvapakshi. To that the ichataha, thereby the sutrakara says bhaktam vanatma vittvat tatha hi darshayati. Bhaktam vanatma vittvat tatha hi darshayati. भाक्तम वानात्म वित्वा तथा ही दर्शयति. सो भाक्तम वा अनात्म वित्वात तथा ही दर्शयति. श्रुति ही दर्शयति. श्रुति शोज व्हाट? भाक्तम इज शोज गौण. दिश्रुति इज गौणस एज इज सीन बाय अदर श्रुति. the shruti quoted by Purvapakshi, tad devanam annam tan deva bhakshayanti, that shruti is bhakta. Bhakta means it is in the secondary meaning, gauna. It is not literally that the jivas become anna for the devas, but it has a gauna meaning. And but why does he say it say so? So there the sutrakara says anatmavit, va is to say that, or there is another meaning. Why do you take that meaning as literal? Says the Siddhanti to Purva Pakshi, therefore this va is in that meaning. Then anatmavitvat, because these jivas who go to Chandraloka, they are not jnanis, they are not atmajnanis, they are ajnanis. They may have shastra jnana in the sense that they may have karma kanda jnana, and they may have followed that to completion expecting punya. Therefore, they may have the vijnana regarding karma upasana, but they don't have atma jnana, atma vijnana. Therefore, anatma with, they are anatma with. Therefore, anatma vitvat, being anatma with, being those who are ajnani, is therefore this shruti is saying in such a manner in a figurative sense. Meaning, devatas, you are like a pashu for devatas. Another shruti says that. So, tatahi darshayati, another shruti, that we will see in the vritti. Vashabdaha chodita dosha nirasartaha. Whatever objection has been pointed out by the Purvapakshi to say that that objection is not valid, the va shabda has been used by Bhagavan Sutrakara. Tesham ishtadhikarinam jivanam, those jivas who have done the ishtapurti karma, for them annatvam bhaktam eva, that annatvam being food for the devatas, their being food for the devatas, that is bhaktam eva namukhyam gaunam. It is secondary, not in the primary literal sense. Anyatha swarga kamo yajeta iti shruti vyakopasyat. Otherwise, what will happen? This ishtapurti karmas have been learned from the dharma shastras, which are based on the shruti proper. Swarga kamo yajeta. Swarga is in the sense of sukha. So, whenever anyone wants sukha, what should one do? He should do the karma which will lead to swarga. That is what the shruti says. So swarga kamo yajeta, and yaga is the primary means to swarga. Thereby shruti which is committing, the faultless shruti, the shruti which has no defects, it is free from all defects, that kind of a shruti has said swarga kamo yajeta. Swarge kamaha yasya sa swarga kamaha, so that is an adhikari who wants swarga sukha, so he should do yaga. And having done yaga, if the annatvam, that annatva shruti is mukhya, then what will happen is that this shruti vyakopa will be there. The swarga kamo yajeta shruti will have made a commitment which is not living, it will live it up to, because what that shruti is saying, that you will attain sukha. Finally, he becomes anna. So, there is becoming anna is actually dukkha. Dukkha rupa. Being consumed by someone else. You can imagine the dukkha there. So, shruti vyakopasya, that shruti will be angered. Because you are compromising meaning and you are showing a fault in the shruti as it has not resulted in whatever commitment it has made. Ataha tesham anatmavitvat, because these ishtadhikaris are anatmavit, they have done ishtapurti karma hoping to get some result in another loka, thinking that sukha is separate from themselves, and thereby they do not know their sukha swarupa atma, and thereby they are anatmavit. And due to that reason, anatmavitvat, deva upabhogyattvam eva annattvam. What is that annattvam? Annattvam is deva upabhogyattvam. They are using the jivas for their own worship, etc. So it's a win-win situation. We serve the devatas, and then devatas give us the ishtaphala. So in the loka, it is a give and take relation between the jivas and the devatas. Since the jiva cannot get what he wants, he asks for the anugraha of the devatas. Oh, give me this, give me that. And for that, he does whatever it takes to please the deity, Ishta Devata Ityadi. And thereby, devatas being pleased by offerings, devatas give that which is that is unattainable by jiva by himself. Thereby, the devatas help him out. This is the give and take relation. It is similar to the pashus. Now, another shruti says that devanam pashuhu. Why? Because we have seen it earlier. Just like we domesticate some animals for our purpose. So the cows are taken care of not only because Shastra says that, but also many of them without knowing the Shastra also, they take care of cows because the cow gives milk. So for our own purpose we do it. And if there is overproduction, then we sell it as well. So it becomes a business. And where is the poor cow supposed to go? Today, there are not many fields. So, if you let out the cow also, it is dangerous. The cow will end up on the roads, blocking traffic, or the cow will start eating into others' gardens. Or, unfortunately, garbage today. So, the cow has to be dependent on the owner to be fed. Thereby, the owner is taking care of the domesticated animals, but the owner has more benefit than the cow has. And cow is an upalakshana for pashu. Therefore, the pashu is also counted in the dharma shastras as what? As dhana, the owner's dhana. And this is exactly how the devatas are taking care of the jivas like pashu. So devatas are giving what the jiva wants, but then the jiva is serving a higher purpose for the devatas. Thereby, Shruti also shows, tatahi darshayati atha. Where does the Shruti show that this is should be gauna? Atha yo anyam devata upaste pashureva sa devanam. One who worships other devata, other than whom? Other than this parabrahma tattva. Other than the Parabrahma Atma Tattva, Anyam Devatam Upasthevanu worships, what about him? Sa Pashu Eva, Devanam Pashu Eva, he is as though Pashu for the Deva. There is no as though there, Eva has been mentioned, not Eva, but still we won't like to be called as Pashu. So we'll have to tone it down for our own, ego as to, oh no no, I am doing dharma karya, I am better than others. Yes, I am better than others, but my comparison is with the adharmika. When I start comparing myself with a atmajnani, with an atmajnani, then I am equivalent to a pashu, says the shastra. Therefore, this annatva is bhakta. It is gauna. Does not mean that literally anna, but being taken care of the devatas for their own purposes, and no devata would like to miss the praise and worship. Therefore, they also present obstacles for the sadhakas in getting atmajnana. Ityadi shruti rityartha. Therefore, it is gauna. The annatva shruti is gauna. Tasmat paraloka bhogartam bhuta samparishvaktasya rahanam iti siddham. So, in the adhikarana, what was the interpretation done in the first sutra as to Rauhati Gachati, this jiva, who is that? Sukshma Bhuta Sukshma Parisamparishvakta, one who is connected with the Bhuta Sukshma, Sukshma Sharira, that kind of a jiva has gati towards another loka and back. Tasmat Paraloka Bhogartam, for the purpose of bhoga in another loka, Bhuta Samparishvaktasya, the Bhuta Sukshma, Bhuta in sense, the Bhuta Sukshma Samparishvakta, one who is connected, that jiva has Rahanam, Gamanam, Iti Siddham. This is established. So the adhikarana is over. The new adhikarana is krutatya adhikarana. That adhikarana is introduced by Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra as purvam karma samavetanam apam panchamahutau purushatmana parinama shravanam hetumashritya abadibhuta pariveshtitasya jivasya rahanam muktam. What was said earlier in the earlier adhikarana is in the fifth ahuti, jala becomes in the form of the purusha jiva. So karma samavetanam apam, which kind of a jala becomes jiva in the form of purusha jiva in the fifth ahuti? That jiva which is connected, that jala which is connected with the karma. Based on the karma there is travel, so that karma, sanchita karma ityadi is held together. Whatever is ripe for fructification, based on that there will be paraloka gamana, and there the jiva who is born of this jala will have, or jala, we have seen the jala and jiva connection there. And thereby there is karma phala bhoga in another loka, and once that is exhausted, then in the same jala in the fifth ahuti becomes jiva in this loka, and purushatmana parinama shravanam hetum ashritya, taking that as the hetu for the parinama, for the change of the jala which is connected with jiva's karma into jiva in the fifth ahuti, in the panchamahutau. So in the panchagni vidya section, taking that hetu ashritya as basis, what? Abadi bhuta pariveshtitasya jivasya rahana muktam. So one who has gamana is what kind of a jiva now? That jiva has the paraloka gamana or back, who is pariveshtita, abadi bhuta pariveshtita, who is connected with the sukshma of the jala ityadhi bhutas. He is connected there. And that sukshma sharira is holding the karma in the bija avastha. So which was mentioned tadayuktam. So yaduktam tadayuktam. What has been mentioned by the Siddhanti, Purva Pakshi says that is not tenable. Swargad avarohatam jivanam karma bhavena sat samavetanam apam apyabhavad iti akshepa sangatya. Why is it not tenable? If the Siddhanti were to ask, the Purva Pakshi says, why is it not tenable? Is because swargad avarohatam jivanam, the jivas who are returning from sarga, falling from swarga, they don't have any karma. Karma bhavena. So what are you saying, that there is karma connection of the jalas, meaning sukshma, sukshma ausha bhuta sukshma, sukshma sharira which is made up of mahabhutas, the sukshma ausha is holding the karma connection. This is what you are claiming. And therefore in the fifth ahuti, that karma unfolds as prarabdha of the jiva, and jala, meaning the jaladi bhuta sukshmas, which is actually the sukshma sharira holding the karma bija, fructifying as prarabdha for the jiva's janma, takes the form of the jiva. This is what has been mentioned in the fifth ahuti. This is what is happening. That is not valid. Why? Because there is no karma at all. This jiva who is exiting swarga, where is the karma? He has not made any karma. Only after the birth he will make karma, right? So where is this karma, whereby the claim made by the Siddhanti as to the bhuta sukshmas are connected with the karma? That karma does not exist. Where is the connection, pray tell? So how is it valid? It is not valid. It is untenable. Swargad avarohatam jivanam, the jivas who are having avarohana from swarga, they do not have any karma. So karma bhavena, what will happen? Tat samavetanam apam apya bhava. There won't be anything called as bhuta sukshma jala or jaladi bhuta sukshma itself. Why? Because you are claiming that jala ityadi is in the form of connection with the karma. Karma not being there, such jala is not there. There may be jala all right, but there won't be jala the way you are taking as to being connected with the karma of the jiva. Karma not being there, jala the karma connected jala won't be there. There may be jala, but there won't be karma connected. Tat samaveta meaning karma samaveta, karma samaveta nam apam. The jala which is having connection with karma won't be there because karma itself is not there because the jiva is exiting swarga. There is no karma he has done now. Iti akshepa sangatya idamaha. With that akshepa sangati, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, Kritatyaye anushayavan drushta smriti bhyam yathetam anevancha. Kritatyaye anushayavan drushta smriti bhyam yathetam anevancha. So he says, Kritatyaye anushayavan drushta smriti bhyam yathetam anevancha. So the Siddhanti is saying as to Purvapakshi's claim of Jiva not having any karma while he exits Swarga, he says Krita, whatever is done, Krita Atyaya meaning at the exhaustion of the karma which has fructified into Swarga Vasa, Swargaloka Vasa. So he says that the Krutatyaye Sati, when there is end of whatever karma was Krita and thereby Punya was Prapta by this Jiva, when there is exhaustion of such karma, then Swarga exit takes place and thereby what? Anushayavan. Anushayavan means Matupanta. One who has Anushaya. What is Anushaya? Anushaya is whatever is remaining. There is remaining karma. It is not that all the karma has fructified to Swargaloka Vasa. There is only very little karma which is Punya attained across multiple Janmas, but still it is very less compared to Anadi Janma Prapta Karma. The karma which is sanchita, accumulated across janmas since beginningless time, that karma is so vast that this swargavasa is just a fraction of it. Let it not be a fraction, let it be a large chunk also. Even if it is a large chunk, still the balance karma is there. That much has to be accepted because not all karma can fructify in a single swargalokavasa or other Janma. In a single Janma, in a particular Deha, not all Punya and Papa also which are opposing to each other be exhausted. They cannot be exhausted. Multiple Janmas in multiple Kalas, in multiple Dehas, in multiple Deshas, in multiple Jiva forms, in multiple Yugas, Ityadi will give some relief to the exhaustion, meaning some relief in the form of exhaustion of the prapta karma, but not entire karma. Thereby, there will always be a remainder of karma. Karma can never be exhausted by bhoga because no janma is going to wash away entire set of karmas. It is only a sum of punya and papa here and there. That's all. To even imagine that someday I'll exhaust all my karma is impossible. Prarabdha karma you can exhaust, after which the body would fall off. My body will fall off when I exhaust my prarabdha karma. Prarabdha is karma which is carved out of sanchita. And not only that, in this very janma I am accumulating more and more karma. So karma phala which is due will also be stored in bija avastha. So all of that agami karma will also go and join the sanchita once I drop this body. Therefore sanchita will never exhaust by karma, karma bhoga. So krutatyaye, whatever is punya krita which has led to swarga, at the end of only that set of karmas, what will happen? Krutate anushayavan. This jiva who still holds the sanchita karma, which is anushaya, which is remaining, that entity, anushayavan, that entity will continue to have samsarana. He'll continue to have. So krutate krutanam karmanam atyaye samapte anushayavan. Who is that anushayavan? Sheshakarmavan. So this entity jiva is always sheshakarmavan. Not only this krutate there is karmanam atyaye. Does not necessarily mean swarga only, but in this example swarga, in any exhaustion of prarabdha, still balance sanchita karma is there. So the jiva at the end of any karma phala bhoga, whether it is at the end of his janma or end of some karma which has resulted in some sukha or some dukkha, still he will be holding a lot of karma in prarabdha also, let alone in the in sanchita. Sanchita is extremely vast. You can say tending to infinity, because anadikala karma has to be infinite only. But we prefer not to use the ananta shabda there, because ananta is reserved for Brahma. From our perspective, we would like that ananta for the Brahma lakshana. So therefore, we don't use it. But there is nothing wrong in saying that karma is also ananta. As a backlog, it is ananta, but ananta shabda also has a connotation that it will never have an end. It will have an end. By jnana, it will have an end. Therefore, to avoid confusion, we do not use the word ananta for the karma, sanchita karma. But sanchita karma being anadi, it has to be tending to infinity. You are adding and subtracting very less. We are adding more, but we are removing very less of the karma. Therefore, there will always be more and more karma which is held to be fructified later in bijavastha. So, krutatya anushayavan jivaha. Why? What is the pramana for that? Hetu drushtasmriti bhyam. Drushtasmriti bhyam. And thereby what? Yathetam means yathagatam. As drushtasmriti bhyam, yathagatam and anevamcha. Na evam anevam, meaning viparitam, meaning as there is basis in karma, so is the travel. The gati is based on yathayetam, means ita, the ingato dhatu is there. So we will take artha as yathagatam. So whatever is gata, gatam anatikramya, whatever is attained by the jiva in karma, based on that there is a gati. So the paraloka gamana and viparita also, returning also, is based on meaning avarohana and arohana and avarohana. Both are what? Both are based on the karma. So where the jiva has to go and where he has to return, all that has basis on the remaining karma, anushaya, which is balance, which jiva has. Jiva is not letting go of the karma that one has earned. Therefore, yathetam and anevamcha, that is what the drishta shruti, the shruti and smriti shows. We'll see more in the vritti. Atra purva pakshe avarohatam karma bhavena tad anuguna tiryagadi yoni praptyayogat na karma phaleshu vairagyam. So here purva pakshe, in the purva paksha, what is there? Avarohatam karma bhavin, avarohatanam kesham jivanam. The jivas who are having avarohana, who are having fall from swarga into in the on karma bhumi. So how can there be jiva bhava for jala in the panchama ahuti? And thereby the birth takes place, because birth should have some karma there. There is no karma. Karma bhavena tad anugunita tad anuguna tiryag, anuguna, following that, anupashchat. So tadanu is karma anu. So karma bhavena tadanu karma anu, there won't be any janma. Janma is based on karma and karma is not there. Therefore tadanu karma anu, what is that? guna. So tad anuguna, based on the gunas which follow the previous karma. What is that guna leading to? Tiryag adi yoni prapti. So tiryag is the ones who move horizontally, animals. So animal life ityadi. Tiryagadi yoni prapti, manushya, devata, it can be any. So tiryagadi padena, all types of jivas can be included there. So tiryagadi yoni prapti ayogat. There is no possibility of a janma of any type, tiryagadi, because karma itself is not there after swargaphala bhoga, in this example of swargaphala, at the end of the karma which has led to swarga. Purvapakshi says there is no karma remaining, therefore following that karma, anuguna, following that karma, there cannot be any tariyagadi janma, any jiva janma really. Therefore what? Karma phaleshu vairagyam, which is being claimed by the Siddhanti, because this is what sadhana adhyaya. In the sadhana adhyaya, vairagya is being shown as the cause which has led to the mukshuta, and thereby the sadhana. Sadhana, chatushte sampatti, and then adhikaritvam ityadi, then vishaya sambandha ityadi, with the anubandha chatushtaya, the sadhaka will follow the jnana marga. This is the setup claimed by the, process claimed by the Siddhanti. So this vairagya itself is not possible. If you listen to how the jiva has janma in the panchagni vidya ityadi, there will be vairagya as claimed by the Siddhanti. So karma phaleshu vairagyam, oh, this karma phala, becoming anna for the others, becoming, remaining as a pashu for devatas, taking this janma in such such fashion, being offered as an ahuti into agni, it is not literal, but still listening to that, the journey of the jiva would cause vairagya. But karma phala is lacking, therefore jiva cannot have any janma, therefore this panchagni vidya, which is leading to jala becoming jiva in the fifth ahuti, is not really in that sense, says the Purvapakshi, and thereby karma phaleshu vairagyam, siddhante karmanah sattvad vairagyam iti, na karma phaleshu vairagyam. Why? Purvapakshi is saying, avarohata jivanam karma bhavena tadanuguna tiryagadi yoni prapti yo ayogat na karma phaleshu vairagyam, meaning karma phaleshu vairagyam na sambhavati. Vairagya cannot be the result because karma itself is not there, so Shruti cannot talk about this jiva janma after swargapala bhoga. But Siddhanti says, Siddhante karmanah sattvat, karma definitely is there, shesha karma, anushaya is there, and anushaya one is jiva, therefore vairagyam sambhavati iti phalabheda. This is the difference between the Purvapaksha and the Siddhanta. Evam hi swarginam avarohanam shruyate. Siddhanti explains, evam hi swarginam avarohanam shruyate. How is the journey of the jiva who has had swargavasa, who is having swargavasa? So this swargi jiva has avarohana, he comes down. How? Tasmin yavat sampatam ushitvathaitam evadhanan punar nivartante ityadi. So punar nivartante. Tasmin yavat sampatam ushitva, having bhoga as much as the karma, what does the jiva do now? Punar nivartante, he returns unto this karma loka, karma bhumi. So as long as sampata, as long as one has accumulated the punya karma, he continues to such loka and remains to be in such loka, but then punar nivartante, he comes back from the same yathetam. So yathetam eva adhvanam punar nivartante, he comes back from the same path that he has gone by ityadi. Tatra kim swargad avarohantaha sanushayaha uta Niranushayaha iti sandehe. Now, are these ones who are jivas who are having a return journey from Swarga, do they have balance karma or do they not have balance karma? Sanushaya, do they have balance karma? Or uta Niranushaya, meaning they do not have, jivas do not have balance karma, shesha karma iti sandehe. Niranushaya iti Purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says that Niranushaya, there is no balance karma after Swarga Bhoga because that has exhausted the karma. Siddhantasu, Siddhanti says Krutasya Swarga Prapaka Karma Jatasya Bhogena Atyena Ashe Anushayavan. This Jiva is Anushayavan. He definitely has karma after the Nasha. Atya meaning Nasha of what? Of the karma. How is that Nasha? Bhogena. Bhogena kasya nasha bhavati karma jatasya. The entire karma, which entire karma, not sanchita, that entire samuha jata is samuha which is of karma, which is prapaka, swarga prapaka, meaning that group of karma, that set of karmas which have led to attainment of swarga, there is exhaustion of only those set of, that set of karmas by bhoga, swarga vasa. So by swarga vasa and staying in the swarga loka, whatever bhoga has been done through that bhoga, atyaya takes place of such set of karmas. Atyaya is nasha and thereby anushayavan, he still has all the balance sanchita karma and thereby anushaya shabdena amushmika phalaprapaka karmatiriktam karma uchyate. So amushmika is paraloka, swarga loka. So swarga loka ityadi loka prapaka karma atirikta, separate from that, other than that set of karmas which has led to amushmika swargaloka prapti, that is meant by the anushaya shabda. So balance karma, shesha karma. So karma uchyate tadvan eva avaroti. Tadvan is who? Tadvan is anushayavan, meaning shesha karmavan, meaning that atirikta karma. Which atirikta karma? So amushmika phalaprapaka karma, swarga prapaka karmatarikta karmavan, shesha karmavan is the jiva. Kutaha, how do you say so? Drushta smritibhyam, because such kind of a statement exists. Shruti and smriti exist. Tadya iha ramaniya charana abhyashoha yatte ramaniyam yunim apadyeran ityadyaha drushta. Pratyaksha Shruti. So Pratyaksha Shruti is there, that is meant by Drushta. Drushta Shabda in the Sutra. Tadya Iha. Yaha Iha Ramaniya Charanaha. Ye Iha Ramaniya Charanaha. Those who are Ramaniya Charanaha, they are worship worthy in Swarga themselves. They are enjoying, rejoicing. Abhyasho. So they will have a fall. Ha yatte ramaniyam yonim apadyeran. They attain this swargaloka ityadi. They attain this swargaloka and then ityadya drushta pratyaksha shruti is there and then what? Pretya karma phalam anubhuya tata sheshena vishishta desha kala kularupayu shruta vritta vitta sukhameda saha janma pratipadyante. And having exhausted their karma, what do? Having exhausted the karma, they still continue to other loka based on different karma. So abhyasa, it's a result. As a result, abhyasa, they attain a particular yoni where they'll have this ramaniya bhoga. And then what? Pretya karma phalam anubhuya, having died, having exhausted the karma by bhoga, tata sheshena, balance karma is there, and later, after that, sheshena vishishta desha kala kula. So vishishta kala, in a particular time, prarabdha will fructify, in a particular kula, this person will take janma, rupa, ayuhu, particular ayu will be there, shruta vritta vitta. So based on whatever has been heard, whatever has been the acharana, whatever is the vitta earned, sukha medasa, sukha ityadi, all of this will matter and such kind of a sukha and medha, such kind of a janma, medasaha janma. So what kind of janma will this anushayavan attain? Because anushaya is shesha karma. The shesha karma, out of that another shesha is carved out, another part is carved out, still shesha will remain. That part which is carved out is prarabdha, which is ripe for fructification. And that will result in what? Vishishta desha kala kula roopa ayushruta vitta vritta vitta sukha medasa janma. That kind of janma with a particular medha, sukha, dhana, acharana, shruta can be taken, jnana, and particular ayu, life, length of life, ityadi, rupa. Rupa can be taken separately also. Particular form, particular kula, rupa is particular, look and feel. And then kula, particular family, kala and desha. All this is vishishta, based on the prarabdha. Very difficult to understand how it is put together, and a person gets a janma, and so it's true with each and every jiva. Iti smriti hi. Such smriti is also there. Tabhyam, based on the pratyaksha shruti, and also smriti tabhyam, anushayavantaha eva avarohanti iti gamyate. Anushayavantaha karmashesha vantaha jiva, jivaha. Those jivas who are having balanced karma, they alone will have returned to this karma bhumi. And they alone means masses, ajnanis, all the ajnanis. Techa yena margena chandra lokam arudaha. In whichever manner they have gone to chandra loka, tena eva avarohanti kim tad viparitena ityakangshaya maha. So whether they take the journey in the same manner that they have gone to the chandra loka, or they return in a different fashion, iti akankshaya, when such a question arises, such a doubt may be there as, what is the journey now, the way he has taken, in the same fashion does he go to another loka from chandra loka? There the vritti says, explains this sutra, yathetam anevamcha. Yathetam, yathetam means yathagatam. As he has gone dhumadi margena anevamcha tadvipariyena. So goes to the loka, paraloka, as described in the yathagatam, dhumadi marga, as described in dhumadi marga. But the return is not in the same fashion as dhumadi marga, but the return is in the reverse order. So anevam means tad viparyena. Na evam, na dhumadi marga order. Order is reversed, obviously. So if you are climbing up the ladder, then you will not be climb in the same first rung to 10th rung. Let's say there are 10 rungs on the ladder. Then if you have climbed the ladder from 1st to 10th, obviously when you climb down, you will not be going from 1 to 10, you will be going from 10 to 1 in the reverse fashion. So, anayavancha tad viparyena vakshamana abhradi margena avaronti ityartha. But here, there is a difference as to going is from dhumadi marga, but return is not from the dhumadi marga, because dhumadi marga is like climbing from 1 to 10, and then from 10 to 1 is a different ladder maybe, and therefore vakshamana abhradi marga. The journey is from a path, but the dhumadi marga to paraloka, but return is not from dhumadi marga, it is from a different marga, like climbing down. From climbing down, the dhumadi marga won't work, it's like a one-way traffic. So vakshamana abhradi marga, abhradi marga is there, which is what is described by the in some way by the panchagni vidya avarohanti ityartha. We look at the next sutra in the next part. Long vritti here, and difficult words also. So we'll see in the ninth sutra in the next part. Amnayante samsiddham adi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavadah.